And now we will learn how to manage and record retention from contractor invoices. Retention for contractors is an amount or percent deducted from the total of each individual progress invoice during the project life of the contract. The total accumulated retention from all invoices on the project will be paid at the end of the project. You must account for the changing balance of the retention for each client or job and account for the total retention receivable from all clients in total. You must clearly list the retention amount on each invoice. So how are we going to do that? Well, here's how we set up for that. We create a retainage receivable account to record the total that is owed from all clients specifically for retention from the invoices. Now, we can go ahead and do that now. Okay, list chart of accounts, account new. We learned how to put new accounts. This one will be other current asset, other current asset, and then click continue. Now, the name of it will be, put it in capital letters, retention receivable, because you will receive this money in the future from your clients after the entire contract is done. So now we did the first step of the setup. The second step is to create an item on the items list that is a discount type of item. Now, usually the retention is a certain percent of each invoice, and in our example, we'll make it 5%. So it has to be a discount type of item because that's the item that you would put on an invoice that would decrease the entire invoice by a specific percent. That's why it has to be a discount type of item. And we can call it retention from invoices. Okay, so now we click list, item list, and then we click item new, and then this will be a discount type of item. Discount, and we call it retention from invoices. And the clients will know that that is the item that's listed on the invoice that shows the decrease of the total invoice by 5% that the client will hold until the end. So the account is the other current asset that we just made, retention receivable. So every time we put this item on an invoice, this is the account that will go up by 5% of the total of that particular invoice. And the percent we just put, well, we actually have to put the number 5 with a percent sign because the discount could be either a money amount or a percent. So we put 5 and the percent sign so QuickBooks knows it's 5% and not $5. Click OK. And now we've done the second step to set up for retention. Now we should put the retention report in the icon bar. And the retention report is really an edited version of this report, sales by item detail. That's because this retention is an item and we want to see only the invoices and only the retention amount, only that item. So here's how we do that. From the main menu, we click Reports, Sales, Sales by Item Detail, and we push A for all. Now, there are many others, but what we have to do is filter this report just for the retention item, and then we have to correct its title, calling it Retention Receivable Report. So the way to do that is to click the top left, and then click Filter, and then filter, click in the list of filters and type the letter I on your keyboard so that it scrolls down to this choice item. So again, let's back up a little. open up the sales by item detail, reports, sales, sales by item detail, then customize report, filter. Click in the list of filters, put I for items, click item. Now the item we're filtering it by is this one down here. It's connected to the, it's the discount item. Where is it? There it is, discount. Retention from invoices. That's the only item that's going to show on this report, and only invoices that have that item listed will show up. When I click OK, none of them show up because we haven't recorded any retention yet. Let's edit the title in the header footer so we can call it Retention Receivable Report. Retention Receivable Report. So this report will show us exactly how much is the retention for each individual client, and in the trial balance, we'll find the current asset, the total retention receivable from all clients together. Now let's look at an example. And now let's pin it up in the icon bar, click View, add Sales by Item Detail to the icon bar, and change the title, Retention Due from Clients. And that's what it'll look like on the icon bar. And when we click here, we can open it and see the retention from each individual client, each individual invoice by each individual client. It's great. And now let's invoice each individual month. Let's imagine January 31, we finished 25% of the job, and according to the contract, billed 25% to the client on an invoice, less the retention. Let's see what it would look like. We open the invoice. Make sure you choose the date of the invoice, which is the date you finished the first 25%. Make sure you don't only choose the right customer, but the right job under the right customer. And make sure that you choose the right estimate for that particular job. This is exactly as we learned before, except in this case, we're telling QuickBooks that we only completed 25% of this estimate. And QuickBooks remembers that the original estimate was $100,000. So therefore, this invoice should be $25,000. It means that $25,000 out of $100,000 regarding the work on the contract has been complete. However, you're not going to ask them to pay $25,000 because remember you have retention, which is 5% of the invoice. So the invoice is $25,000 because it represents 25% of the work finished. But from that, we're going to list on the invoice this deduction of 5%, which is $1,250 from this particular invoice for retention that the client will pay only at the end if the contract is correct and properly satisfied. Now look what happens when we click Save and Close. If we open the retention report, we see just for Kirschbaum, you can see that Kirschbaum owes us $1,250 in total retention for the entire contract. If we open up the trial balance, you can see that the account called Retention Receivable that we created is also equal to $1,250 because in the trial balance it represents all the retention from all clients regardless. Now, let's bill them for February 28th and see what happens. Same thing, invoice, same client and job, same estimate, and same 25%. If you watched our earlier videos, you'll be able to follow this quickly, and you can see this is also $25,000 out of the $100,000, but don't forget to put the retention on it, and that means that's another $1,250. Save and close. Oh, you got to put the right date because it was February 28th that we completed the second 25%. Notice the invoice remembers we're up to 50% now of the job. So now when we open the retention report, you can see that there have been two invoices for Kirschbaum at Woodbury. Here, for Kirschbaum at Woodbury, you can see there have been two invoices of which 1,250 was withheld on the January 1, and 1,250 was unbilled and withheld for February 28th. Actually, the date from this invoice, the first invoice, the date should really be the 31st. Sorry about that. Okay, who cares? But when we go to the trial balance, the total retention from all clients is up to 2,500. Let's practice this because of that little mistake by doing the next invoice, March 31. The next invoice is March 31 of the Kirschbaum Woodbury job against the same estimate for the same 25%. And here we are, and don't forget to put the retention receivable, which is also 1,250. So when we go back to the retention report, we see for the Kirschbaum Woodbury job, there have been three invoices that we retained money, 5% each, and these are the money amounts. By the way, if you double click, I don't know why the invoice is not keeping the date. But anyway, double check that the date of the invoice is according to the billing of the contract. But notice when I double click and open it up, you can see that only 1250 is the retention. It's a negative 1250, but only the retention amount is list of that particular invoice is listed on the retention report. Now, the interesting part happens at the very end of the contract, April 30th. April 30th, we make another invoice for Kirschbaum at Woodbury against the last part of the estimate for the remaining and final quarter, 25%. We make sure, again, that we try putting April 30 on the debt. I don't know what's going on there. But when we put the retention, okay, that 1250, save and close. Now, look what happens. If we open the, if we open the retention receivable report, we see these are the invoice numbers and dates that were billed to Kirschbaum, and this is the amount of retention on each of those invoices. That means that there's a total of 5,000 retained. Now, before we ask Kirschbaum to pay us the 5,000, we're going to look at the report that we learned about earlier, job progress invoice versus estimate. And we can see for the Woodbury job, even though 100% of the work has been done, and technically 100% of the work has been billed, the only reason it says 95% is because we withheld 5% for retention. So if you open up each invoice, the first invoice had 25% complete, but it decreased it by 5% of that. The second invoice showed we're up to 50% complete. The other invoice showed we're up to 75% complete. And the last invoice showed that we were up to 100% complete. So why does the report say 95% complete? Because 5% of it is sitting here in this retention receivable report. And 5,000 total retention for one client is all we have. And that's why right now, retention receivable in the trial balance is 5,000. The total that all clients owe us for that. And when it's time to ask Kirschbaum to pay for the retention, all we have to do is print this report. If we print this report and we give it to Kirschbaum, the client will be able to see the dates, the invoice number, and money amount retained from each invoice. This way, the client can open up the copy of that invoice to verify that that was the amount of retention properly calculated and listed on each of the past invoices that we gave him, so that he can check that this retention receivable report is correct and pay the $5,000. So don't forget, when the contract is over, give your client the report as the bill, as the invoice that requests the payment. This way they can verify everything. Now, I have to do another example and make a vital point. If you put more than one income item on an estimate, you will need a subtotal item on the invoice to properly calculate the retention. This is because the retention item only calculates a percent of the item directly above it on the invoice. We have to go and do that now. It is very, very simple, but you'll need to do this. Watch. List, item new. The type of item is subtotal, and we can just basically call it subtotal. If you think of a name that better suits you, you can go ahead and use it. But watch how it's used in the example. And this example will bring everything together regarding the ideas of retention. On January 1, we made a contract with Brown Company for Lillian Court, $30,000 in carpentry and $20,000 in electrical work. 5 months, no money down, invoice 25% each, 25% complete. So each month, whatever moment we finish, the next 25%, we send the bill. And the retention is still 5%. So those are the terms. And by the way, don't worry, because I already put the job and the estimate into the computer behind the scenes off camera to save time. So the first thing we're going to do, let's go back to the terms and find out what they were again here. Okay. Actually, the terms were down here. Okay. January 1 for $30,000 of carpentry and $20,000 of electrical work. Now we can open the estimate. Okay. We go down to Lillian Court. Here's the estimate. You see, let's just expect it's $30,000 in carpentry and $20,000 in electrical work, and $50,000 overall. So when we make our first invoice on January 31, make sure we choose January 31, we choose the Lillian Court job for Brown, we choose the only estimate available for that job, and again, we're doing only 25% complete in this example. Now, notice it automatically calculates 25% of the total estimated carpentry and the total estimated electrical work. Now look at the problem. If you choose retention, it's only going to show you 5% of the item directly above it. That's why you cannot put this item here. You must put the subtotal first, then under the subtotal, put the retention. Now the retention reflects 25% of the entire invoice, not just 25% of the item above it. Click save and close. Now when you look at your retention report, okay, I don't know why. Oh, okay, look at this. Okay, it's not sorted by customer, but you can. You can see that for Brown and Lillian Court, you can see this. Now, what you can do on this report is filter by name. And of course, if you studied how to edit reports, filter by name, and you want this specific job, Lillian Court, click OK. Now you have only the invoices that have the retention item for Lillian Court. And you can print this and send it to Brown Company for Lillian Court when this accumulates the total retention. One very last thing. When you open your trial balance, why is retention receivable $5,625? Retention receivable in the trial balance represents all the retention that is owed to you from all your clients together. And if you double click, you can see each invoice and each date and number and each retention amount.